When developing a web interface, we may have a challenge when we want to have a smooth web interface. It means when we need to do transition between elements, but we'd not like to have this transition being so abrupt, in sense when we are going to hide one element and display another element, and that happens in a way so immediately and user cannot see exactly what was out and what has just arrived to his interface. Then for this proposal, CSS has the transition property. With this property, we can define a duration for when CSS property move from one value to another. So in case we are going to make one element bigger or smaller or visible or invisible or from one color to another color, this change may vary and based in one effect. And the goal of that is we have web systems with web interfaces that is going to have this smoothly transition between the property values. So let's take a look how to do that now. First, let's see the simple example in which we have these icons here. And when a user interacts with some icon, we display a text below that describes what this icon means. Okay, but as you can see, we have some information displayed, and when we change to another icon, the whole content is replaced immediately. How it happens? Okay, if you take a look at the code, we have here the information we display in the interface, handled by this class here, technology description, in which is not displayed. And when user interact with that, we just change the display attribute from none to block, and then we make that effect. Right, now we are going to see the possibility with transition. Now let's work with the transition attribute. Okay, so instead of working with this display attribute, change that from none to block, that has this effect that's more abrupt, we are going to work with transition. Transition, as I have said in the beginning of this video, do not work for all kind of attributes, like display, or even like visibility. However, it works for width and height. So what's the idea here? When we change the width or the height of a certain element, this transition of this variation in the value of the attribute will take the time in seconds informed here. So you can play with these values. I have set it here from 1 to 2 seconds because I don't want my user to wait too much just for seeing a transition. But you can play with that and have different effects. So that's the situation here. So instead of having the property non-defined, I just set, okay, not visible, hidden, but when hidden, it takes the space in the web interface, so visibility hidden is different than none. However, if I use visibility hidden, width 0 and height 0, then it's the same behavior. Okay, so I have changed here the purpose this way. What I have to do when user interact with one element? The function that before changes just from none to block, now will do a different behavior. When changed to none, actually, is change the dimensions property to 0 and visibility to hidden. And instead of change the visibility to block, change the visibility to visible, and then define here properties for height and width. Doing that, let's see the behavior in user interface. Let's run that again. And here, as you can see here in the website, what's going to be the behavior? As you can see, when we change from one element to another, what it does? It hides the previously displayed element, and the new displayed element was with the width and height with zero. But when changing, we defined a new width and a new height. And then we have this effect because it takes this amount of time to go from one value to another value. And then instead of just replacing the whole text at once, we have this transition effect. So it's just a visual stuff. There is nothing about functionality here, but you may bring one smooth transition to your user interface. So that's for this video. Thank you for your attention.